So guys, using straight lines, now we are going to draw an object. So I have an example of this Canon battery charger as my object. So I'm going to draw this object in a 3D form. So there are certain techniques to draw this. So first step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a horizontal line. So it is of 180 degree and a vertical line. So why I'm doing this is like to judge the angle of the object, like how it is placed. So here you can see the object is something quite angular. See, I'm just keeping the pencil here so you can see how it is placed. Why I have chose this angle is to make it more interesting, so I could see all elevations, like top elevation and also the side elevations. So first step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to judge the height of the object. So height, it depends on the size of a sheet. So how much of space you have and like how well you can compose. So I've just randomly chose the height here. So this is the first step. So this is a very important guideline which is going to help you out to construct the entire object. So I'm just comparing the height here. So here you can see this is the height of the object. So here you can see this is an height of an object. So I've just drawn this line here. So using that line, I'm supposed to construct the other elevations. So how I'm going to do that? See, there are different ways. So many of the artists use their pencils like this, like a foreshortening, and then draw the entire object. Either you can do that, or else you can just randomly through your eyesight, you can just compare the height, width and length. So you can also assume how many times does this make to to find the side elevation. So I'm just assuming that it might be somewhere about 3 times. So guys, if you notice, there is a negative space which is created here. It's very, very important. So I've just drawn another elevation here. So using this, I'm supposed to construct the length of the object. So here you can see I'm drawing the other line. These lines are also parallel to each other, and the length seems to be little longer compared to this. So here also you can see now the length is more and the width is less. So this height and this height is quite parallel to each other, and then I'm going to draw another line which is parallel, which is similar to this, like 1, 2, and 3 are similar. 1, 2, and this 3 are similar. So I've just drawn a block. So next step is breaking down this cuboid into the object. So how I'm going to do that? See, I've just drawn these two diagonal lines to find the center here. And then if you see the ratio here, it is like somewhere about 40%. It's not exactly the center, it takes 40%. So this is the center, so this little bit below makes it 40%. Right? So again, you can see there is little space here. So I'm drawing this little space, and then there is some depth. Again, there is some hollowness, the depth, and here you can see I'm using the straight line as my guideline to draw this curve. Here you can see I'm drawing this curve. And guys, if you have noticed, I'm not using the eraser. Why? Because if you're using eraser, it means you're not confident and you'll not end up with the final drawing. It's okay to scribble it. It's okay to make mistakes. It's fun. So scribble as much as possible so you'll start enjoying the drawing. See, here are the round edges here. And then for the font, you could use the same technique. So here comes the font, scan on. So guys, I'm just doing it fast. And take your time for the detailing. So guys, you understood like how to draw the object with proportions using straight lines and curved lines. So I'll meet you in my next video where I'll be teaching you about different types of lines and different types of shadings and also light and dark.